It felt like hours that Noel and Jenny chatted over coffee. Talking to her was easy, despite everything, and Noel wondered more than once at how on the same page her head and heart were. They left the wooden cafe and paused outside to say goodbye.
"I know I keep saying it," started Noel, "but it's really nice to be spending time with you again, Jay."
"Just nice?" Jenny asked, and Noel's heart did a small bounce. Was that flirting?
"More than nice. Really very extremely good, actually."
"Well, I thought so too," she agreed. "But don't get any ideas."
"I won't,"
Noel answered. Too late. Noel's intention wasn't to start up anything with Jenny again. It was too complicated. They were too out of touch. But she missed everything about her. She wondered briefly if it would be cute or weird to learn the Bieber sorry dance routine to try and win her back.
"Can I see you again? As friends?"
Jenny tossed her hair back as she laughed. "What am I getting myself into? Yes, that would be nice. As friends. I'll come over and help with some renovations on my days off, if you like."
"I would like that."
Jenny left towards her shop, while Noel walked the other way to meet her sister. If she told herself a few weeks back that she would be here, under the autumn sun, smiling and flirting with her first love, she would have laughed herself out of her courtroom. Ray waited for Noel outside the nicer sweet shop, where she'd stocked up on some nibbles to help get them through the last of the bedroom clear-outs, which they really needed to get on with. The centre of Maplewood was preparing for Halloween, in the understated way a rural market town in England does. Pumpkins carved into grisly, grinning faces were popping up on doorsteps and windowsills, and cutouts of black cats and witches decorated windows. As Ray stood there admiring the scene, Kelvin wandered past. He stopped and grinned at her.
"Still here, Ray?"
he asked unnecessarily.
"I could say the same to you,"
she answered. She looked at his chubby head and sweaty body. He really hadn't blossomed, this one.
"I've got a joke for you, right? How long does it take three hippies to paint a house?"
"Dunno. Go and visit the Lake Sisters in a year or so and they'll tell you,"
he guffawed. Ray stepped back to avoid being showered with spit.
"You should really spend more time looking at your own life than looking at ours. It's kind of weird."
"It was just a joke, man. Chill out."
"I'm very chill, man. I just think you're kind of obsessed. Why do you even care what we're doing?"
"I don't know. Maybe because we're buds."
He looked at her like she was a right thicko. She was shocked. "We were never buds. We were buds with everyone. You were popular and people worshipped or feared you."
"Did you think you were everyone's friend, though?"
"Yeah, of course."
"But you tortured people. Me and my sisters, to name a few. It was a joke. God, you on your period or something?"
Ray threw her hands in the air.
"I'm not on my period. I'm just trying to have a conversation with you. Do you even realise you were a massive dick-for-brains bully?" "Shut up, was I?"
Kelvin was clearly getting uncomfortable now, and he started to walk away.
"I wasn't a bully. You're the bully, bitch."
He walked off grumbling. But it was a good thing. Ray realised you can't win them all, and while she wanted the Halloween party to mend some fences and maybe even make this a nicer place for her mum to live, going forward, she realised she didn't have to bow down to the bullies. Kelvin and Tom did not need an invite.